Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will understand what is common mode rejection ratio in op-amp. So if you see the data sheet of any op-amp, then you will find that out of the many parameters, the one parameter which is defined for the op-amp is common mode rejection ratio. So let us understand in this video, what do we mean by this common mode rejection ratio and what is the importance of this common mode rejection ratio in op-amp. Now, usually this parameter is defined for the differential amplifier, and in the earlier introductory videos of op-amp, we have seen that op-amp is also differential amplifier and it amplifies the differential input signal which is available between the two terminals. So let's say if voltages V1 and V2 are applied to this op-amp, then the output of the op-amp in open loop configuration will be open loop gain multiplied by the difference between the two input voltages. So here this gain is known as the open loop gain or simply differential gain because it amplifies the difference between the two input voltages. Now suppose if two input voltages V1 and V2 are equal, in that case the output of the op-amp should be equal to zero. Or in another word, we can say that if two input terminals are tied together to the common input voltage, in that case the output of the op-amp should be equal to zero. So this configuration where two input voltages are equal or the two input voltages are tied together to the common input voltage, that configuration is known as the common mode configuration. And the input voltage which is applied to the both input terminal is known as the common mode voltage. So in ideal condition, in this configuration, the output of the op-amp should be zero. But actually if you see, some voltage will be available at the output. And this output is known as the common mode output voltage. Now usually this output voltage used to be less than the applied input signal, or we can say that the ratio of this output divided by the input is always less than 1. So this ratio or the gain is commonly known as the common mode gain of this op-amp. So now let us see some of the sources which acts as a common mode input signal for this op-amp. So the most common source for this common mode input signal is the 50 or 60 Hz noise signal, which used to be present at the both input terminals. Apart from that, whenever the circuit is operated in a high electromagnetic field, in that case, the electromagnetic interference which is coupled to the circuit is also common to the both input terminals. So these are the some of the sources of the common mode input signal. Now suppose if we apply the differential input signal to this op-amp, in that case, the output of the op-amp ideally should be equal to this differential gain multiplied by this differential input voltage. But because of this common mode input signals, you will see the another term in the output, that is common mode input gain multiplied by this common mode input signal. So this term basically represents the common mode output voltage which appears at the output side. And for any op-amp, this term should be as minimum as possible. So in another words, we can say that op-amp should be able to suppress this common mode input signal which is present at the both input terminals. And how well it is able to suppress this common mode input signal is defined by the parameter which is known as the common mode rejection ratio. And it is the ratio of this differential gain divided by the common mode gain. And in decibel, it can be represented as 20 log of this differential gain divided by the common mode gain. Now, usually this parameter is defined for the open loop configuration. And in fact, the discussion that we have carried out so far is also for the open loop configuration. But in practical cases, this op-amp is used as a differential amplifier in a closed loop configuration. So the value of this common mode rejection ratio, which is listed in the data sheet for the open loop configuration, can be used approximately for the closed loop configuration. And using this, we can find the common mode output voltage, which is present at the output terminal. Now usually this differential amplifier is used to amplify the differential input signal which is coming from the sensors, and many times this differential input signal used to be a very small value. So now whenever this differential input is comparable to the common mode input signal, in that case this common mode rejection ratio used to be a critical parameter. So in that case it is important that this differential amplifier should be able to suppress the common mode input signal which is present at the both input terminals. So based on this, let us take one example and let us understand how well the differential amplifier is able to suppress this common mode input signal. So in this circuit, op-amp is used as a differential amplifier in a closed loop configuration. So here the differential input that is being applied to the input terminal is a 1 kilohertz sine wave with a peak value of 5 millivolt. And here the common mode input signal or the common mode noise which is present at the board terminal is a 50 hertz signal with a peak value of 2 millivolt. And for the given circuit, the common mode rejection ratio for the op-amp is 90 dB. So let us find out in this example how well the circuit is able to suppress this common mode input signal. So first of all, let us find out the output voltage whenever the differential input signal is applied between the two terminals. So in the earlier video of differential amplifier, we have seen that for this configuration, the output voltage can be given by the expression R2 divided by R1 multiplied by the V2 minus V1. So here the ratio of this R2 and R1 defines the differential gain of this amplifier. And here the difference between this voltage V2 and V1 is nothing but the differential input voltage which is applied between the two terminal. So we can say that the output voltage is nothing but the differential gain multiplied by the differential input voltage that is applied between the two terminals. So in this example, if you see, the value of R2 and R1 are 10 kilo ohm and 1 kilo ohm respectively. So we can say that for this circuit, the differential gain is 10 and the differential input voltage that is applied between the two terminals is a 1 kilohertz sine wave with a peak value of 5 millivolt. So for the given circuit, the output voltage will be a 1 kilohertz sine wave with a peak value of 50 millivolt. So this will be the output voltage because of the differential input that is applied between the two terminals. Now let us see the effect of this common mode input signal which is present at the both terminals. So here the common mode rejection ratio for the given circuit is equal to 90 dB. And as we have discussed, we can approximately consider this value for the closed loop configuration. So we can say that CMRR that is equal to 20 log of differential gain divided by the common mode gain. Or we can say that the differential gain divided by the common mode gain that is equal to 10 to the power 4.5. And if you calculate this value, it will be roughly around 31623. So we can say that the common mode rejection ratio for the given circuit is equal to 31623. Now, as we know, it is nothing but the differential gain divided by the common mode gain. So we can say that the common mode gain will be equal to this differential gain divided by this common mode rejection ratio. Now here for the given circuit, we have found that the value of this differential gain is nothing but 10. And we have already found the value of this common mode rejection ratio as 31623. So this will be the common mode gain for the given circuit. Now the common mode output voltage can be defined as the common mode gain multiplied by the common mode input signal. Now here we have already found the value of this common mode gain, that is equal to 10 divided by 31623. And here this common mode input signal is a 50 hertz signal with a peak value of 2 millivolt. So if you calculate it, then we will find the value of this common mode output voltage as 0.63 microvolt. So at the output, we will get the common mode output voltage of 50 hertz with a peak value of 0.63 microvolt. So in this way, this differential amplifier suppresses the common mode input signal which is present at the input terminals. And how well it is able to suppress this common mode input signal, it depends upon the value of this common mode rejection ratio. Now this common mode rejection ratio is also a function of frequency. So as the frequency will increase, the ability of the circuit to suppress this common mode noise will also reduce. So for the given example, if the common mode input signal which is present at the board input terminal is a high frequency noise, in that case the circuit will not be able to suppress that noise as efficiently as it was able to suppress the 50 hertz noise. But in that case, suppose the input signal frequency is way less than the high frequency noise, then still the input signal can be filtered out using the low pass filter. So these are the some design aspects which you should need to take care of while designing the circuits. So I hope in this video you understood what is common mode rejection ratio and what is the importance of this parameter in the op-amp circuits. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.